Keep your eyes open. I think this asshole's using a stealth
board. Disappearing, Arthur!
Someone there!
Hatch! Hit like a rad roach! Hot potato! Just stand still! Bailing you!
That sound, what is it? Spineless human! Be a good boy!
Wish a buckethead would show up. I'd rip his legs clean off.
Getting hungry.
What's that?
Thank you.
someone there. You have to come out sooner or later.
Hello? Someone there. Play tricks on me again.
You hear? You hear? Stop hiding.
What? Who's there?
I can smell you out there, little snake. I can hear you. Fucking kill! Yeah, human, human, human. I got a treat for you.
No fight today.
There we go. That's it.
Come out, wherever you are!
Gone now. Pity. Someone there.
Stupid noises. Ah, what's that? A noise? Thank you.
going up. Third floor.
Boo!
Wanted a fight. Let's play, little human. Someone there.
Yes.
Thank you.
nice.
Hey there.
We'd all considered putting a bullet in Coulter's back at some point. Suppose you just beat us to it.
Nice.
Don't be caught dead!
Saw you poking around that abandoned house. From Commonwealth weaponry. I'm gonna assume McDonough gave you permission, and leave it at that.
Hey, you're back. You know, there's another case Nick never got around to wrapping up, tracking down one Earl Sterling. Check it out if you're interested. Thanks again for closing out the Nakano case. You never know where some of the hard ones are going to take you.
Hey.
Always a trail to be followed.
Perfect.
The Earl Sterling case. Apparently Earl just up and disappeared one day. No one's seen him since.
The Super Salon can give you the hairstyle of your dreams.
Kim, I care, cares about you.
Did you see the explosion? That blimp the Brotherhood had. The whole sky was on fire.
I wanted so much more from my life than this. Ugh.
Hi, Darcy.
Don't let my husband drag you into any of his nonsense.
Just buy or sell whatever you need and get lost.
Hey.
What? Oh, no. Whatever it is, keep it to yourself.
Hawthorne.
Hey, what's your story? Mercenary? Caravan guard?
You first. What's your name?
Hawthorne. And you are definitely from out of town. I know every settlement from both sides of the Charles River, and I've never seen you. Anyway, I'm just kicking back and sharing stories while I'm between things. I've been all over, seen vaults, pre-war ruins, and plenty of monsters.
You've been to a vault?
Yeah. Ever heard of Vault 81? They're standoffish, but every once in a while, they'll let new people in.
So you explore old ruins?
Last place I was going to check out was Salem. Real old town far to the north. Never made it, though. Got a bad feeling about that area.
See you around, Hawthorne.
Later.
Paul and I have a child.
Hey, Hawthorne.
If you want to know what's out there, you can ask.
But not
or you can always experience the bone-shattering dread of the Commonwealth for yourself.
Let's hear your best monster.
Trust me. You don't want to know what they're capable of.
See you around, Hawthorne.
Yeah, take it easy.
I'm busy, excuse me.
Yeah?
You ain't gonna last once you leave the wall, so don't get chummy.
If you're hungry, we sell food, but usually people just order drinks.
Did you work with Earl Sterling at all?
Oh, yeah, Earl. Ugh. I mean, I know I shouldn't speak ill of the missing, but that guy needed to get out more. You'd think a bartender would be smooth, you know? Charming? Not Earl. He tried so hard, too. Way too hard. The real sad thing? He thought it was his looks. Kept talking about getting a new face over at the mega surgery. Wouldn't have helped. Anyway, I gotta get back to serving drinks.
Who owns this bar, anyway?
The Bobrov brothers picked this place up a few years ago. Vadim Bobrov is the loud one, Yefim Bobrov is the quiet one, and I'm the one that has to listen to them argue with each other all day.
Not looking to buy right now.
Fine.
What, you lost? I ain't a tour guide.
Vadim.
Drinks! The finest liquor moonshiners can brew right here.
Earl Sterling used to work here, right?
Poor Earl. Gone just like that. Such a good bartender. Good friend. Oh, terrible with women, mind you. Bull in China shop with them. You with Valentine's Detective Agency? I forgot to drop off Earl's key when I hired you people. Here, I hope you find out what happened. Security does nothing but yell at me for asking about it. Now, let me pour you a drink. Come on.
Not interested.
You sure? Ah, well.
Here you think Diamond City is a rust bucket. Well, if you don't like it, you ain't gotta stay.
a reason for bothering me, get lost.
Minter! Buff out, stim packs, jet, everything to even you out.
Doc.
We offer a wide variety of medical treatments.
Do you know anything about this receipt?
Let me see. This is Dr. Crocker's deplorable handwriting, all right. Looks like Earl Sterling was one of his patients. The procedure noted here is mundane. Low-risk cosmetic work. Dr. Crocker never performed it, however. Said Earl vanished before he paid. Now, let's get back to talking about your medical needs.
Where is Doc Crocker?
Last time I saw him, he had to get something out of the surgery cellar. Probably just had to wash some needles or move some storage around. Anyway, we should get back to your immediate medical requirements.
I need to get into the cellar, Doctor.
What does this look like? A public outhouse? You know what? Don't answer. Why on earth would I let you down there?
I'm investigating a missing person, Doctor. And I think the trail leads to your basement.
A missing person? You're talking about Earl, aren't you? You can't honestly think... You know what? Fine. If it'll put the matter to rest, here. Go see for yourself. But if I find one instrument out of place, you'll be getting the bill.
You there. We need to talk.
Is there a problem?
The problem is that I've learned that you killed my son Nelson. Is this true?
Yes, it's true. I killed him.
You son of a bitch! At least tell me one thing. Why did you do it?
I'm sorry he's dead. Things just got out of hand.
I appreciate that. Nelson, he... Well, I know he was no choir boy. I always hoped he'd get that out of his system and make me proud one day. That's done now. I just... Yeah. Thanks for being honest.
Keep looking at me like that. I'm gonna start thinking you're a synth.
You really are hard to get rid of. Perhaps the direct approach. Go away!
Where'd all this blood come from? It goes right into the basement.
Oh, Earl. You've really been a handful, you know. But I think we're just about done. Our little mistake is finally going to be corrected. Oh, naughty, naughty. You're not supposed to be down here, but that's okay. I can fix that. I can fix anything.
Take it easy, Doc. Let's talk about Earl.
I didn't mean to do it. You have to believe me. Doc Crocker is a brilliant surgeon. No one dies under his care. No one dies. They just walk away happy. Happy with my work. Happy with their new face. Not screaming. Not bleeding out onto the floor. Earl, he just didn't want to be happy. That must have been it.
You made a mistake, but you can still do the right thing, Doctor. Just think this through.
You're right. There's one thing I can do. Only one thing is going to make this all better. I can fix anything.
What's going on here? Is that Dr. Crocker? I think you owe me an explanation. What?
Doc Crocker killed Earl Sterling. I found out, and then he killed himself. Guess he couldn't handle the guilt.
Dr. Crocker killed Earl? The facial reconstruction. So he really did go through with it.
That explains a lot more than I'm comfortable with. Dr. Crocker always cared about his reputation, but this is inhuman.
What are you gonna do now, Doctor?
Now, I have a report to file, a mess to clean up, and a lot of explanations to give to our patients. You should get going. A medical professional should be the one to handle all this contamination.
Skull in the league can withstand a swat.
So, you find out where Earl Sterling ran off to?
Earl never went anywhere. Doc Crocker killed him during a botched surgery.
Crocker killed Earl? Gone as long as he was, I figured maybe Raiders or the Institute, but Crocker? Where's the doc now? Rotting in a cell, I hope.
Crocker killed himself. He couldn't take the guilt.
Goodness. I'm sorry you had to go through that. Here, take this. Sounds like you earned it. I'll send word along. Let everyone down at the dugout inn know what happened. Shame it couldn't be better news. Thanks again for closing this one out. Did you ever find what Marty was looking for? That man didn't get out of bed for free. So I have to imagine it was a pretty nice haul.
Means a lot to me in my business. You helping clean out the water supply. What can I get you?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Hey, everyone's got a drink, am I right?
Attention. In the event of an emergency, remain calm and obey all safety
Please
and shelter
stand
instructions
clear of the doors.
Provided by Nuka World employees. Thank you.
Por favor.
Madangase anahat. Hello, and on behalf of the Corporation, we'd like to welcome each and every one of you aboard the Nuka Express monorail. For your own safety, please remain seated or utilize the provided handrails while the train is in motion. If you'll direct your attention to the right side of the monorail, you can observe Nuka World's famous Fiztop Mountain. Standing at over 100 meters tall, Fiztop Mountain is the largest man-made structure in Nuka World and features the 5-star Fiztop Grill. Coming up in the heart of Nuka World, Nuka Town, USA, featuring the Cola Cars Arena, the Brad Burton Amphitheater, and the Parlor Dinner Theater. And kids, don't forget to tell your parents to bring you to the Nukacade, where you can play games and earn tickets to win fabulous prizes. From Nukatown, USA, you can access any one of our 5 individually themed parks. Experience the future at the Galactic Zone, or relive the Wild West at Dry Rock Gulch. Take a tour through the Nuka-Cola bottling plant, or visit Kitty Kingdom and meet the whole Nuka family. And finally, for the nature lover in you, travel to Safari Adventure and delight in over 100 different animal species from around the world.
Going up. Nuka Express. Nuka Express. Going up. Transit Center.
Well, hey there. What brings you all the way out here?
Making a new friend, I hope?
Absolutely. The name's Evan. I've been out here for years now. I guess you could say that I like the peace and quiet. And the view. Well, look for yourself. It's something else. Since you took the trouble to find me, least I can do is return the favor. Need any supplies?
Sure, that'd be great.
Glad to help. Let me see what I've got. Here you go. I found this on the outskirts of Nuka World a while back. It isn't doing me any good. Well, it's been nice having a visitor. Feel free to stay for a while and help yourself to anything else I have laying around the place. Don't mind me. I'm just gonna hang out around here and enjoy the view.
Boss.
Back.
There's machines here that used to spray kids with Nuka-Cola. What was wrong with those people?
Over, boss.
Making trouble? Good.
Nisha really only has one rule around here. Don't get caught. Wouldn't hurt to tip the scales a little in our favor, you know?
Understanding the operators ain't hard. We know how to live. The other games.
Need something, boss?
Come with me. I need your help.
Yeah, okay. Sure. Anything in here?
Galactic Zone's impressive, sure. Did you ever feel like that giant Andy's just watching you? Mags, William, and Lizzie. All you have to do is hear them speak to know they weren't born into this life. They sure as hell were born before.
You see that crazy robot dressed like a bottle?
Don't worry about me. I'll stay in line.
Not looking for trouble, just some good... deals. What are the other gangs gonna do with Nuka World? Turn it into a slaughterhouse? A barn? Only makes sense to give us run of the place.
There's some bad jobs here, but cleaning up the Pack's hideout is the worst.
Hi there! If you have any questions about Nuka World, I'd be delighted to answer them. And remember, if you collect a full set of park medallions, I'll give you a special reward.
Not supposed to hurt the other gangs. No rule against tricking them into hurting each other. Plenty of back alleys and blind corners around here.
Hope you're having fun in Dry Rock Gulch.
Finders keepers, am I right? sure was fun. Huh, boss? Look like shit, but damn if they can't move. Watch yourself. don't leave anything behind, if you can help it.
Thank you. nice work. We're in for a fight.
What's up, Bob?
Something for me? You're the overboss.
Got it.
One way, there we go. Or another. Still useful after all this time. What's up? Thank you.
key. We need the key.
Thank you.
Heads up.
What you need?
Look alive, Gage.
Yeah.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
Yes. If you're missing an item, stop by our lost and found at the main gate. Your item will be returned to you for a nominal fee. While touring the Gorilla House, please refrain from making rude gestures to any of our primates.
Galactic Zone's impressive, sure. Did you ever feel like that giant dandy's just watching you?
Looks like we got ourselves a good, safe spot to take a breather.
I see it. Either you wind up getting shot, or you're the one holding the gun. I know how I want it. About maybe finding some cover.
Hey.
Was a bet gonna see who could down a mutie from the longest distance? William made a whole mess of caps that week.
Boss, back again. Was worried we might have scared you off. But who can keep away from a place like this? You decide how you want to convince these folks to pay up?
Let me talk to them. I'll get them to hand over what we need.
Sure, sure. So, which crew you want keeping an eye on the place once you get them to bend the knee?
The operators.
I'll send word along. Now, the target. It's going to have to be a settlement close to our outpost. Joint called Nordhagen Beach, I think, is close enough to work. Could be a good target, though I'd need to check my notes, of course. So, where you want to do this? Huh. Was that... Believe that spot's one of yours, boss. Still want to proceed?
Actually, I changed my mind.
Sure. You want to give me another target? Or did you maybe want to change up the job?
Let's do a different target.
Sure thing. So, where do you want to hit? Huh. Was that... Oh, that place. Isn't that one of your old stomping grounds? Sure that's the one?
That one's the target.
Of course, boss. So, to get these settlers to cough up provisions, they need to know that we aren't a crew to be trifled with. You can try convincing them to pay up, or you could rough them up some. Let them know we mean business. Tools from the operators could also make your life easier. Plus, having an outpost nearby gives us another option. Claiming the airwaves. Building a Nuka World radio transmitter at an outpost within range of the target will let them know we're closing in on them. Your Pip-Boy map should show you which outposts are close enough to serve. And if none of that works, well, I suppose you could always try paying one of them to convince the rest. And it's worth remembering, the more populated or heavily defended a place is, the more prep work you're gonna have to do to get them to bend. Just bring us back something nice.
Hey, you.
Hey, you, wanna tell me what you're doing here?
I'm here to make you an offer. This place will supply me and my friends in Nuka World caps, food, whatever you got. In exchange, we won't bother you.
Oh, I don't know. A lot of hard work goes into this place. Can't just give it to you.
How about you and I make a deal? You get this place supplying my people, I'll make it worth your while.
You'll pay me? I guess I can do that.
Hey, everybody. Bad news. We got some new management.
How about you buzz off?
There's a lot of yapping about wiping us out.
Then I guess we'll just have to let them know who they're dealing with. You did good. Now get going. The adults are gonna discuss this. Figure this would happen sooner or later. Our outposts caught the attention of some of our new neighbors in the Commonwealth. An outside crew of raiders think we're honing in on their territory. Sounds like they're planning to tear the place up, and our people with it. Suppose this provides us a good opportunity to make an example. You thinking what I'm thinking?
Mayhem and destruction is what I'm thinking, for what it's worth.
What can you tell me about this gang?
Not a whole lot. Our scout said the boss calls himself Sinner. Claims to have a decent-sized crew ready to take what we stole fair and square. Suppose he just needs to learn who his betters are. So, are you and I of the same mind on how that ought to get done?
I want to try talking to them.
So that's a no, then. Look, boss. Your clout may get you what you want around here, but that doesn't earn you a thing with raiders in the Commonwealth. All those mutts understand is force, and I think it's time you and them came to just such an understanding. But you should probably get going. You wouldn't want to keep our new friends waiting. Wouldn't be neighborly.
Hi.
Good. You're here. Spotted those dogs? Not far off. Things are about to get fun around here.
Commonwealth raiders. Got no respect.
Who's in charge around here? I'll tear their heart out. You! You, the Nuka World waste pile that thought you could move your gang into Sinner's territory and live? You give me one good reason I shouldn't slice you open and eat your heart right here.
Sinner, it doesn't have to be like this. We can be stronger together than we ever were apart. Join my gang!
Are you fucking kidding me? I will wear your bones. Kill them! Help!
Stop right there! Shank.
Heard some rumbles. This one didn't get you either. Figure I shouldn't be surprised.
Those raiders won't be causing us any more problems.
That's what I've been hearing. So I suppose your recent success brings us to the next step. Loyalty. Without loyalty, everything that's yours ain't. And to keep a crew loyal, you need to keep them happy. Now, keeping raiders happy isn't real hard. Just have to make sure they've got their basic necessities, just like any other settlement. That they've got some things to keep them entertained, and that their food's taken care of, which, with raiders, well, isn't like dealing with other settlements. Now, if you want me to go into detail on any of that, you just say.
What can you tell me about entertainment for the outpost?
Think pick-me-up stations or getting one of your crew working on a booze still will certainly help lift your outpost's spirits. And if the place has got a Nuka World transmitter powered up, you can construct amplifiers to help as well. Anything else I can answer for you?
Tell me more about providing food for the outpost.
So, managing your outpost's food can get a little tricky. No one ever joined a crew to dig in the dirt, so you'll want to make sure you've convinced enough settlements to supply your gang. People at the outpost can farm in a pinch, but they sure as hell won't be happy about it. Now, if you're ever wondering if your outpost has enough food, you should take a look in your Pip-Boy. It ought to have a page that'll show you everything your outpost currently needs, food included. If they're low on grub, it's probably time to get a new settlement supplying you. Or you could always drop some food direct in their workshop if it comes to it. Now, was there something else?
I want to know more about managing the outpost's basic necessities.
Day-to-day needs. They're pretty straightforward. Just need to make sure you've set up solid defenses, plenty of beds under cover, and enough clean water to go around. Not much more to it than that. Was there anything else?
I think I've got everything I need to know.
Sure. If you've ever got more questions, you come find me. Or you can always consult that Pip-Boy on your arm. No better tool to tell you what your outpost may be hurting for. Now, depending on the state of the place when you hit it, this first outpost might already have some of the bare bones set up. All you've got to do is build up what's missing. If you want to run some jobs to convince more settlements to start sending supplies, well, you know how this works. You just come talk to me. And I was thinking, with the outpost coming as far as it has, might be time I set up shop there. Save you a trip anytime you want to run a job. You just let me know if that's something that'd interest you. Be good to make some trouble in the Commonwealth again. So, there anything I can do?
Answer some questions for me.
Shoot.
Is there anything our outpost needs at the moment?
Improved defenses is the word going around at the moment. Couple more turrets or guard posts ought to do it. So, was there something else?
What do I need to take into account when intimidating settlements?
Well, the bigger and more fortified your target is, the more work you're gonna have to do to get them to crack. But using tools from the operators, building a Nuka World transmitter within range of the settlement you're trying to target, they'll make it easier. Plus, the more outposts you've got nearby your target, the more interested they'll be in what you've got to say. You had any other questions?
Remind me, what's the best way to keep outposts happy?
Well, you want to make sure they've got all the necessities, defenses, beds, water. And beyond that, you could build them some entertainment, a booze still, pick-me-up station, an amplifier if you've got a Nuka World transmitter set up. And if you're wondering what they're lacking, best thing to do is check your Pip-Boy. It's got a page with all the information you could need on what your outpost might want. I'm also willing to share whatever I hear. And lastly, don't make them farm. Lose a lot of goodwill from your gangs by making them pick fruit. Was there anything else?
That was it.
Got it. Something else I could do for you?
I want you to head to an outpost.
Yeah, sure. Where am I going? Suppose I better get a move on then. See you there, boss.
Thank you.
dog. He's acting weird. Sick or depressed or something.
Yeah. There's only one solution for that. Bullet to the back of the skull.
You sure are smart about this stuff.
I try.
Don't tell no one, but my beast stopped minding me.
Feed and exercise it as often as you can. Tie some meat around a slave. Let him chase him around a little.
You're a goddamn genius.
You do know you're gonna get yourself killed, right? Hmm. Place is looking good, boss. Everything a gang of lowlifes could ask for. So, you ready for the final piece of the puzzle?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Good to hear. Because what you've made is a foothold. To solidify our place, our outfit's gonna need some real numbers. Two more outposts carved from the Commonwealth ought to do the trick. Get all that together, and, well, we'll have a real base of power on our hands. With that kind of clout, we'll be able to start setting up dealers at our outposts, get to selling stuff like real damn towns. We keep expanding from there, we'll even be able to set up spots where the locals can come drop off tribute. But I'm getting ahead of myself. For now, you'll want to start by claiming another two outposts. You just let me know whenever you want to get rolling on those jobs. So, boss, what's the plan?
Nothing for now.
All right.